Your revelation of God affects your relationship with God. So it's important to have a Bible, a scriptural revelation of God, to know who God really is, so that you and I can then relate to Him based on truth, based on who He really is. So God wants His love in us and through us. So God, our Heavenly Father, He not only invites us to receive His love, He says, look, I want you to do what I'm done for you. I want you to love others the way I have loved you. And when you and I walk in love, that is a sweet aroma to God. It's a sacrifice. It is an offering that's well-pleasing to God. So walking in love is your act of worship to God. It's something that you are offering up to God whenever you and I choose to walk in the love of God towards people, towards one another. And so the love of God should undergird every expression of the gifts of the Spirit, should undergird other functions we do, all of that. So walking in love is walking this much better way of serving people. That does not mean we do away with the gifts, but we take that path, and as we walk that path of love, then we express the gifts and fulfill our functions. Love never fails. 1 Corinthians 13, verse 8. Now, many times we use that statement, but we don't understand, like, you know, what did Paul actually mean when he said, love never fails? It means that we will not get off course. You will not fall down powerless. You will not fall down ineffective. Life is going to have difficulties. So he says, we glory in tribulations. We glory, I mean, even in the hard times. We're not down, upset, discouraged. We glory in tribulations. Why? Because we know what this is all working towards. Tribulations produces endurance. Endurance builds character. So, tribulations develops endurance. You stay in that endurance mode for a while. It builds character. And character produces hope, expectation. You say, I've gone through this. It's too late for me to move back. It's too late for me to turn back. I have hope, expectation of what God said. I know He's coming. I know I'm going to be with Him. I have that expectation. I have hope. The love of God floods of our hearts by the Holy Spirit is given. So don't feel sorry for me. We glory in tribulation. We glory while our endurance is being developed. We rejoice while our character is being shaped and forged. We rejoice. We have this hope in our hearts. This hope will not shame us, because right here and now we're enjoying the Father's love. Loving as God loves expands our revelation of His love. He says in 1 John 4:12, no one has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God abides in us, and something else happens. His love has been perfected in us. That word perfected means to come to its full measure, to achieve its intended purpose, to accomplish its intended purpose. His love fulfills its purpose. His love grows to its full measure inside of us. So when we love other people, our revelation of His love also expands. So when you love somebody, say, God, I'm finding it really difficult to love this person, but because Your love is poured in my heart, I'm going to love him. I'm going to love him. When you love him, your experience, your understanding, your revelation of God's love also becomes that much bigger. As I love, what will happen? As I love more, what will happen? Your revelation of the Father's love will also increase. His love will be perfected in you. You understanding this? The best way to experience, to have a greater revelation of His love, is to love as He loves. Just go on.